Hi guys, I'm back with part two, as I promised. Now, what we're going to do here, let me move this back into the chat. What we're going to do here is present E through K now. These are the SOM Hall of Famer cards from Stratomatic Hall of Fame Edition. And as an example of what I'm doing, for those of you, if this is your first video, if you didn't review part one, these cards, these SOM cards from the Hall of Famers, from Stratomatic Hall of Fame Edition, do not contain the teams that these Hall of Famers played for. So what I've done is I've researched it, and I've got all the names of all the players within the set, I believe, to the best of my recollection, I've got all of them listed, and there's going to be a four-part series putting them into the text. So the text to this video is very important. You'll be watching part two here. So it'll begin at E and will end at K. The reason this is being done is because YouTube only allows a certain amount of characters to be presented within the text. So I had to split it up into four different sections. So this is part two of presenting the teams that the Hall of Famers played for in your Stratomatic Hall of Fame Edition game. Also, I didn't mention this in the first video, but it probably would behoove you to cut or paste or copy and paste the text from this video into a notebook file so that you have your own record of these Hall of Famers. I would do it in alphabetical order. Part one, part two, part three, and part four. And then that way you'll have the same list that I do. And you won't have to return to the videos unless you like returning to the videos and you want to help me out and boost my views. But it's not required. I'm doing this because I love the game. So that's a little tip for those of you who know how to cut and paste or copy and paste into notebook or WordPad. Do that, and then you have a permanent file for the Hall of Famers. Now, I did make probably made a few mistakes. I think I put a couple of managers in there who shouldn't have been in there because, as you know, Stratomatic doesn't put managers into the game. But you'll know it'll say manager in the spot where the position is placed. And you can just ignore it. I don't think I did that too much, but I might have did it two or three or maybe four times. So anyway, this is part two. E through K. Enjoy. Like I said, this will be your reference point when you're playing the games. If you what I'm going to do basically is this Hall of Fame edition, I was trying to play games, right? But that is not going to work out. What I'm going to do is I'm going to replace each player on his original team with a Hall of Fame card. That way, that All-star player from that particular team will always be maximized and always play at their very best, which will probably mess up the algorithm for Stratomatic, but hey, everybody wants to play their players at their best in their best season, right? I do. So anyway, that's what I'm going to probably do. So you can probably do that too if you want. I'm not telling you what to do. Just suggesting. So anyway, that's the end of part two. Part three will follow shortly. Thanks guys again for viewing these videos, especially the Stratomatic community, which is the first community of gamers that I was in my life. I think I started playing Stratomatic when I was 13 or 14 years old. Little League, Senior Little League, somewhere in there. But anyway, enjoy, guys. Thanks for watching.